is one of those rare occasions, once every 7 years, when the fourth Sunday in Advent and Christmas Eve both fall on the same day. So we celebrate the fourth Sunday of Advent this morning. Tonight at 6 and 9, we celebrate Christmas Eve and the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ. So we invite you back for those two services. The early service is a carol candlelight service. The later service is a carol communion service. So we have you pick as you sit or come at 9. We begin this morning with the order of confession and forgiveness on page 94 in the front of your worship book. So I invite you to turn to page 94 and invite those who can do so without difficulty to please stand. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Almighty God, to whom our hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another.
Most merciful God,
we confess that we are captive to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that you may be light in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your holy name. Amen.
God, who was rich in mercy, loved us even when we were dead in sin and made us alive together with Christ. By grace you have been saved. In the name of Jesus Christ, your sins are forgiven. Almighty God, strengthen you with power through the Holy Spirit, that Christ may live in your hearts through faith.
Amen.
We now begin our worship by singing verses 5 and 6 of hymn number 257, O Come, O Come, Emmanuel. Verses 5 and 6 of 257, O Come, Emmanuel.
Pray to the Lord.
Lord, have
Dimitrov, sing the song.
Thank you. The second reading is from Romans 16 chapter. Now to God who is able to strengthen you according to my gospel in the proclamation of Jesus Christ, according to the revelation of the mystery that was kept secret for long ages but is now disclosed, and through the prophetic writings is made known to all the Gentiles, according to the command of the eternal God, to bring about the obedience of faith. To the only wise God, through Jesus Christ, to whom be the glory forever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Pastor and Gina Pollock will be lighting the Advent candles.
Thank you.
Now
Messiah came about. His mother Mary was pledged to be married to Joseph, but before they came together, she was found to be pregnant through the Holy Spirit. Because Joseph, her husband, was faithful to the law, and yet did not want to expose her to public disgrace, he had in mind to divorce her quietly. But after he considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins." All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet. The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and they will call him
Thank you.
for joy to the Lord all the earth. Burst into jubilant song and music. Make music to the Lord with harp and the sound of singing, with trumpets and the blast of the ram's horn. Shout for joy before the Lord, the King.
Thank you.
let them and gone into Bethlehem, into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, let us go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about. So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the babe, who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things saying, glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests.
Born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Let us pray for all the people of God in Christ Jesus, and for all people according to their needs. Our response today is, hear our prayer. Lord, the time of preparation is almost over, and your visitation is near. Keep us focused on the gospel and the preaching of Jesus Christ. May it bring about the obedience of faith in us and all who hear your word this season. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Lord, we thank you for those who look out for our well-being and protect us from harm. Give your blessing and protection to police, to firefighters, to medical workers, to the members of our armed forces, and to all first responders whose vocations put them on the front lines of danger, trouble, and disaster. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Lord, nothing is impossible with you. You sent your Son into the world to be the great physician of body and soul. Give to all who are ill comfort and healing, if it be your will, and patience and trust, that they come what may, you are with them. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Lord, while we wait the coming of your Son, we remember with thanksgiving those who were before us in the faith and are now with you. Keep and preserve us in the one true faith to life everlasting, until you bring us together with them into your eternal kingdom. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
In your hands, O Lord, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy, through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen.
You may be seated.
But deliver kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. May Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit bless, comfort, strengthen, and keep you now and forever.
Amen.
Now let us sing verses 7 and 8 of O Come, O Come, Emmanuel, hymn number 257 in the back of your worship. Verses 7 and 8 of O Come, O Come, Emmanuel, hymn number 257.
Thank you.